two of the hardest hitting middleweights in the world come fist to chin, hopefully. Iran Barkley showed his power by flattening Thomas Hearns a year ago, and Michael Nunn's record of 23 knockouts speaks for itself. Let's join our American colleagues ringside for the big confrontation.
And so we're ready to go. Michael Nunn, the reigning IBF middleweight champion, defending his crown against Iran Barkley, trying to regain a world title, one he lost in February of this year. Carlos Padilla, the referee, we would remind you early, he is a referee who does not get too involved when boxers are fighting on the inside, which could help that man, Iran Barkley. He will just slap their gloves away and let them fight. Nunn showing more movement early here than even some would anticipate. Talking to Barkley already and flicking out the jab. They want him to do, but Iran Barkley not hitting him very easily, instead getting nailed with counter shots from Nunn. Very dangerous tactic by Michael Nunn, but it works. And by the way, these ropes are very, very, have a lot of give in them. Remember Ali against Foreman and Zaire when he stood against those ropes and let them absorb the shots Foreman was hitting him with. That looks like Nunn's strategy. Boy, they are really roughing each other up on the inside, and as I said, Carlos Padilla loath to get in there. Big warning to Iran Barkley right off the bat, and the same to Michael Nunn. It's a street fight in the first round, folks. They're yelling from Nunn's corner to tell Padilla to watch Barkley's head, feeling like he might be butting a bit. You see Padilla just pushing the gloves away. Barkley lands an uppercut, and Nunn just kind of shakes his head like it didn't hurt him. Nunn lands a big shot on the inside. Well, Michael Nunn is not running. He is wailing away with Iran Barkley. He looks like he wants an early knockout, and he is nailing Barkley with big shots. Some said it would be bad for Nunn to do this. So far, it's working for him. But then Hearns also did this, and eventually Barkley nailed him. Nunn has Barkley on the end of the jab. Michael Nunn has landed some major league shots in this first round. Big uppercut by Nunn, and a left, but Barkley with a left hook. A big hook by Barkley may have stunned Michael Nunn. There with Barkley exchanging. Not what many expected from Nunn in the beginning of this bout. Big right by Barkley. Half a minute left to go in round one. Nunn with the uppercut and the left. It's been primarily Michael Nunn, but Iran Barkley has been there with some big shots. Nunn with his hands at his waist. Wild first round. Blood from the mouth of Iran Barkley. Nunn landing uppercut after uppercut. It's been Michael Nunn the warrior, not Michael Nunn the boxer in this round. Some post-round activity. This man came here to prove something, folks, Michael Nunn, and he's trying against Barkley. Iran Barkley didn't have any trouble catching Michael Nunn in the first round, but as Nunn predicted, he didn't like what he found.
You're loading too fast. Double down and place your punches to the outside and then work to the inside. You know what I said now?
Yeah.
Place your punches. Work to the inside and the outside. And double down.
What the heck are
you doing? Move that head down. Don't let that head not stationary. Okay?
This bout could hardly have started at a quicker pace. Now, Nunn counterpunching off the ropes. The uppercut, an important weapon for him, and the left hook. Three-punch combination by Michael Nunn. But Iran Barkley, and I think we're going to see a left hook, yes. People wondered what would happen when Michael Nunn got nailed with a big left hook by Iran Barkley. Well, that was a big one. Nunn looked stunned for a moment, but didn't come close to going down. And by the way, as we head into round two, if you're wondering whether Michael Nunn has ever been down, early in his career against Carl Jones, he was hit with a perfect left hook, went down, but came back to not only win the fight, won that round. Now Nunn showing a little bit more movement from Barkley. Now this is what Nunn did against Juan Roldan. Many thought it was a mistake, but he wound up winning handily. Nunn just laying on this one. Jab of Nunn, of course an important weapon, gets in against Barkley. Remember this about Iran Barkley, and remember it as you look at Nunn rain punches on him. Tommy Hearns did the same thing to him over three rounds. Couldn't stop him. There's the jab of Nunn, trying to keep Barkley at bay with it. They clashed heads there. A warning by Padilla to Barkley. Big hook by Barkley. He's finding the range with that hook. The right hand low of Michael Nunn, and Barkley's hook is getting there. Nunn with the uppercut and the right hook. Both of these men are superb body punchers. Both Barkley and Nunn go to the body as well as any middleweight, any boxer, period. We're in round two. It's scheduled for 12 for the IBF Middleweight Championship of the World. Michael Nunn putting his title on the line against Iran Barkley, and it's starting out like almost every Barkley fight does. There's a war. Barkley throwing inside, not landing against Nunn. Nunn smothering those punches of Barkley and fighting on the inside as he did against Roldan. This is almost exactly the way he fought Domingo Roldan. A chopping right hand by Nunn. If he has a weakness offensively, it's that he tends to slap with his right hook. Good left hand by Nunn. Padilla having a tough time getting in between these two boxers. Nunn may have stunned Barkley with one of those lefts. Big left hand rocks Barkley. Another. Nunn getting a little wild, but landing with Barkley. Remember, Barkley was down against Olajide, got up to beat him. It was hurt against Hearns and beat him. After the bell, Michael Nunn lands a punch, and I mean it was way after the bell. We will go into the corner of Iran Barkley.
You swing him inside, and you're not hitting him out here.
Right.
Now you bring him, put the punch on the outside, and bring him out here. Understand?
I can't go to order, Iran. Spit to your right. Spit to your right. Good to right. Get the bucket there.
Yeah. Couple deep breaths. All right, now you're starting to really slip now and counter. That's what I want you to keep doing. Walking around him. As he moves in, you move to the side. Keep the jab out. Mike, keep the jab on. Just keep doing what comes naturally to you. Because
right.
You're doing it. Okay, here we go. Gargle that a little bit.
Both throw yourself out of position. And hook real hard. Okay.
Go, Iran Barkley came into this fight at least a 9-1 underdog in the betting odds. And even though Nunn has had the better of it over the first two rounds, Barkley hardly looks like a 9-1 underdog. You heard them tell Michael to counter, move, not get in so many exchanges with Barkley. That's a little bit what we're seeing right here. They want him to just walk him around and then land those punches. The more movements you give Iran Barkley, the more problems it gives him. In those first three rounds when Hearns was nailing, Hearns was giving Barkley lots of good lateral movement, but still setting down on his punches. And I think I might see some swelling around the left eye of Barkley. See, this movement from Nunn is a real problem for Barkley, even just a little movement. Nunn
slipping the left hook by Barkley. Body work by Michael Dunn. As I said, both he and Barkley are superb to the body. It's a rough fight. Nunn hitting a couple times after the bell. Barkley holding and hitting a little bit. Nunn laying on the ropes. And Barkley having a hard time getting to him. Nunn with his hands at his waist against the ropes. Barkley ripping on the inside. Nunn with his uppercut and hooks. The hand speed of Nunn evident here in these exchanges. But he's there for some hooks by Barkley. They are waging this battle right now on the inside. Nunn choosing to smother the punches of Barkley, and Iran trying to find some punching room so he can land that left hook. And good uppercuts by Barkley. Barkley showed that punch against Roberto Duran. There's the hook to the body by Barkley. He's got a good one. The Nunn jab, not as crisp as it has been in recent fights, but it's still getting there. The uppercut by Nunn, a big weapon, you saw it there. And Barkley, when you lay on the inside against Iran, you're gonna get body shots, and that's what Nunn is getting right now. And with just under 20 seconds left to go in round three, not as wild a round as the first two, but still lots of action. And Barkley concentrating on the body, Nunn headhunting. Although there is Nunn going downstairs. Pressing the attack as he always does, and Nunn moving backwards against those ropes. Carlos Padilla will have his hands full in this bout. Barkley doing a little holding and getting a warning by Padilla. Padilla reaching in and pushing the glove of Barkley down. Nunn using the jab, but he has been nailed with some pretty good shots in this fourth round by Barkley. Keeping his hands down is Michael Nunn, and I'll tell you, that has created some problems for Michael, keeping those hands down. Now the ropes, as I noted earlier in this bout, are quite loose. Michael Nunn is using that to his advantage by leaning back and helping to absorb some of the power of Iran Barkley's blows. Could that become a safety factor and somebody get thrown out of this ring? That's very possible. Barkley has not fought since February 24th when he lost that match to Roberto Duran, and Nunn has fought only one round during 1989, that against Sambu Kalembe back in March. Contrast that to other years when Nunn was averaging about 7 or 8 or 9 fights a year. So he will fight less in 89 than he's ever fought. Nunn using his jab. The fans chanting, I think they're chanting for Iran Barkley. So Barkley the underdog, and the people tend to root for the underdog. And they are rooting for a little bit for Iran Barkley, even though you can see a good contingent of West Coast fans here for Michael Nunn. Not as many as we normally have seen in Las Vegas for him. Barkley missing a lot, Nunn not landing as sharply as he was in the first couple of rounds. The conditioning of both these boxers impeccable. They are always both in terrific condition. Jab of Nunn gets through. Nunn digging to the body. Certainly Nunn had hoped that he could open up a cut on Barkley. It hasn't happened yet. And Iran Barkley had some surgery on the scar tissue that he had over his eyes. Hasn't bled since then against Roberto Duran. And maybe that problem is all taken care of. Eddie Aliano looking closely at those eyes.
You pulled away. You didn't throw that right hand out there.
I thought you threw that right hand out to the side.
Don't hesitate. Throw that right hand out there and bang with it. Understand?
Yeah.
And put them together.
There you go. Now, please, let me have it.
Well, an interesting contrast in those two corners. And that is a trademark of the Michael Nunn corner. Joe Goosen, primarily the only voice, always calm. They're trying to pump Iran Barkley up a bit. Among the voices you heard in there was Ahmad Bey, a gentleman who is well known in the West as a, well, he's really a gambler, an ex-gambler who bet on a lot of fights in Las Vegas. Was taken into the Barkley camp as an advisor for this fight, a strategist, because he had seen Michael Nunn so much. Nunn using his jab and his uppercuts very well now against Barkley. Iran Barkley has probably fought the toughest competition that anybody in the middleweight division has fought. Among them, Roberto Duran, Olajide he beat, Hearns he beat, lost to Sambu Palembe, fought James Kinchin in the fight he won, beat Mike Tinley. Good uppercut by Nunn. So he has been in with the best. Probably the big weapon for Michael Nunn in this bout would be that uppercut. When he lands it, it really stuns Barkley, and it's there for him against Iran. There's the body work by Nunn. He and Barkley both renowned for it. Right hand misses by Barkley. Nunn is doing a much better job in this round of making Barkley miss and landing his own shot. They got tangled up there. We're in round five. It's scheduled for 12. Michael Nunn and Iran Barkley. In the first three rounds, it was a war. It settled down a little bit, though still an action bout. Competitive, though I would think Nunn is probably ahead on the scorecards at this point. Nunn has basically controlled the tempo. There's the uppercut. Boy, that is the weapon. When Nunn boxes and gives Barkley movement, it's very tough for Iran to deal with. You can tell, just like when he fought Juan Domingo Roldan, Michael Nunn is looking for one punch, and that's the uppercut. There it is. It helped him knock out Curtis Parker. It helped him knock out Juan Roldan, and he is convinced it will knock out Iran Barkley. We'll see. There it is again. Now it's landing with great success. There is swelling around the left eye of Barkley, and I'll tell you, I think I see a hint of red over the left eye of Iran Barkley. Nunn again ripping the uppercut on the inside. That'll do it for round five, a round in which Michael Nunn really established control again in this bout and did it primarily with an uppercut. Let's hear what they say in there.
Yeah.
That's it? Got the mouthpiece?
Yeah, I got it.
See, that's what I wanted. So you were countering a lot sharper off the ropes there. You gave him the first minute and a half to shoot some steam, right? And then you took it to him. Nice.
In Barkley's corner, they are working on what looks like a very small cut over the left eye.
Good. Yeah.
Bang him under that armpit when he's sticking arm out there. Mm-hmm. Bang him right up under it.
Okay.
Keep pushing, please.
Shorten up, Iran. You're working great, Iran. Great. You're backing him up. You're keeping the pressure. Eddie.
Clean up that eye.
A little cheerleading there from Ahmad Bey. I don't know if he's working great, but he is pressing Nunn. And unfortunately, in that fifth round, he got hit with lots of counter shots. We move into the sixth. Barkley, the former WBC middleweight champion. None, the current IBF champion. None undefeated. Barkley at 25-5. And now Michael Nunn using his movement a bit, beckoning Barkley to come to him. It's a more serious Michael Nunn than started out this bout, though. Why shouldn't he be? Barkley has shown him something in this bout, even if Nunn would be ahead, which I would think he would be. Grant Barkley has landed some shots. Barkley hitting on the break, but that may be tit for tat. Nunn has hit him after the bell two or three times at the end of the round. Now showing some of that movement to Barkley, telling Barkley to come out. And Barkley says, come to me. And Barkley says, hey, you're running around the ring. Nunn nails him with an uppercut for his trouble. Now, if Nunn doesn't remind you of a Ray Leonard and an Ali in that posture, no one ever will. I'm not, and Carlos Padilla lambasting both men for their behavior. I'm not suggesting Michael Nunn has reached the plateau of Leonard or Ali, but he has the look of them.
That's it, all right.
Nunn lands the right hand, and I think that left eye is bothering Barkley a little bit. Nunn now landing combinations. Good left hand and a right hook by Nunn. Nunn boxing superbly here against Iran Barkley. Pushing him off, showing his strength and his boxing ability. A dazzling round right now for Michael Nunn. He is taunting Barkley, nailing him with big shots. Barkley flailing away, Nunn pulling him in. An illegal move, and he'll probably get a warning from Padilla for it. And so in this round, Michael Nunn has lit up. Turns to righty, a posture he seldom uses. Nunn just holding Barkley off. And so in this sixth round, Michael Nunn has reverted back to some boxing that some people used to think he did too much of, but in the process, he has landed some major league shots and certainly dominated round six. We've reached the halfway point in this match. Iran Barkley is certainly still there, though probably well behind on scorecards, and this is why. In the sixth round, Michael Nunn came to life, landing good combinations. As Barkley came in, good uppercut by Nunn. We're heading into round seven. The good news for Iran Barkley is apparently that small nick over the left eye is not giving him any trouble. The bad news is he is having trouble hitting Michael Nunn. And there is swelling around that left eye. It is starting to close a bit. And that's the same eye that closed on Barkley when he fought Roberto Duran. Good body work by Barkley. Although a lot of those blocked by Nunn, but still Iran is going downstairs well. Nunn shakes his head, uh-uh. Well, Michael Nunn with only one round of boxing in 1989, getting more work here against Iran Barkley. No question about his stamina or Barkley's, although Barkley did fade against Roberto Duran in their 12-rounder. Nunn using more movement, not landing that often in this round. There's the jab by Nunn. When the fight is in the center of the ring, Iran having a real tough time landing against Nunn. Obviously, it works better for him when he's got Nunn cornered. Sure, uppercut just missing by Nunn. He's loading up for that punch. He wants it, and he feels that's the one that will knock Barkley out. Meanwhile, Nunn trying to work on the swollen eye of Barkley with the jab. It's not landing that effectively right now. Nunn boxing pretty well, though, in the second part of this seventh round. In what is probably the closest round of the last five or six. There's the movement. Tough for Barkley to corner him when he does that. Tough for anybody to hit Michael Nunn when he does that. And some of this crowd picking up the chant for Iran Barkley. He's a long way from home, from New York. And of course, Michael Nunn boxing out here in Reno, feeling this might be more of a home crowd for him. It was at the beginning, but some of this crowd wanted to see Iran Barkley pull an upset. There's the jab by Nunn and the left hand. And the hand speed of Nunn controlling this round now. Barkley has him against ropes but can't land. Michael Nunn is a defensive master, make no mistake about that. You heard as you looked at Michael Nunn was them trying to get the swelling down of the left eye of Iran Barkley. It's starting to be a little bit of a problem as we head into the eighth. I mentioned that was an eye that was closing against Roberto Duran. And remember Duran knocking Barkley down with the right hand over that eye that he couldn't see out of. Well, Nunn started out this bout like he wanted to end it in one. Landed some major league shots to Barkley in the first two rounds, also took a couple. And since then has been a little bit more of Michael Nunn the boxer, although he's hardly running from Barkley and has landed lots of punches. Not easy to knock Iran Barkley out. Ironically, the only man who has done it was Robbie Sims. That back in 1984 about I telecast an amazing match in, and Sims went, rather Barkley went down in the sixth round. Iran now, cornering Nunn, not landing too effectively. Nunn almost contemptuous, landing uppercuts, big shots by Nunn. Michael Nunn ripping him with counter shots. Right hand on the inside. I think part of Nunn's plan was to take Barkley into these later rounds. If he didn't get him early, take him in the later rounds, tire him out, and then go after him. That would fit with this scheme right now, making Barkley throw a lot of punches. Landing a three-punch combination, closing the left eye of Iran Barkley. It is really starting to close. Nunn with his hands at his waist, landing the jab against Barkley. Well, right now, Nunn is in control of this bout. And he lands a good right hook, and that will become a big weapon as that eye closes of Barkley. Left by Nunn. Nunn is not getting hit with anything. Iran Barkley is missing 80 to 90% of his punches. That right got in by Barkley. Nunn mugs to show him it didn't hurt, pushes his left hand out there, and Barkley misses with about four punches. Well, it's a boxing lesson right now by Nunn, and if past history tells us anything, it may become more so as Barkley tires. Takes a right by Barkley. Big left uppercut by Michael Nunn. That'll do it for the eighth, a round in which Nunn dominated with his hand speed. we're heading into the ninth round. In the seventh and eighth, Michael Nunn enjoyed big edges. He walks away from Barkley, trying to make him play his game. Nunn, the 26-year-old undefeated IBF middleweight champion. He is 33-0 against Iran Barkley, former WBC middleweight title holder. Came in at 25-5. Michael Nunn has a streak on the line. He has knocked out his last five opponents. Since the beginning of 87, has had 13 fights. 11 have ended by knockout. Right now, Iran Barkley looking to close that streak out, and he'd like to also get himself a win. Right now, here in the ninth round, I have to believe that Barkley is way behind. Although, you never know. I remind you that the judges in this match, Glenn Hamada from Washington, Art Lurie from Las Vegas, and Keith McDonald from Carson City. They're the men who will make the ultimate decision. Barkley lost a very tough decision to Roberto Duran his last time out, one that many believe he might have won. Nunn switching to righty. Halfway through the ninth round. This one less action than the previous round. Punching in this round. You get the feeling he wants to turn it on now, and he does with some jabs. But Nunn has basically taken this round off. I guess he feels he can afford to do that. Barkley's still winging. They want Nunn to turn it on now with less than a minute left to go in the round. He does that with a jab. Michael Nunn, the man who is hunting the legends, Leonard Duran Hearns from Mega Fight, spending his evening here outboxing Iran Barkley, but so far in these later rounds, he's had a tough time hurting Barkley. Barkley going to the, or Iran going to the body, as is Nunn. There's the hook by Nunn and the uppercut. Slipping that uppercut by Nunn. That left hook by Barkley nearly got Carlos Padilla. The round ends. Some stares between these two men. Again, some more action after the bell. We've had that throughout this bout. There's a man that screaming some encouragement to his friend, that Mr. T. I doubt that I need to identify him, but that's who he is. Michael Nunn's buddy accompanies him to every fight, and it's a misnomer to think that Michael Nunn is a fancy Dan boxer who doesn't dig into the trenches. He's one of the roughest fighters around and has been known to bend the rules on occasion. He's a rough man in there. He puts his hand out. Barkley doesn't touch him, instead he's looking to punch him. We are into round 10. It's scheduled for 12. Many believed it would be over one way or the other prior to this. If they believed in Barkley's punching power, they thought he would get him out. Or if you believed that Nunn would dazzle Barkley, either cut him or hurt him, you thought it would be out early. I have Michael Nunn way ahead. There might be a round or two I would give to Iran Barkley, but beyond that, I think Michael Nunn has dominated in terms of scoring.
Good, Iran.
The last round, a round in which Barkley did well early, but Nunn did come back. They yell from Nunn's corner to punch more, and that's probably good advice, because you never know. Barkley doing most of the punching here, but not landing. Barkley, as I mentioned, did fade against Roberto Duran in his last outing after he'd won most of the early rounds, at least in my scorecard, though the judges didn't totally agree with that. In this bout, he is continuing to come forward and throw punches. Fans getting a little restless because Nunn has not done much in this round. none against the ropes. I'm sure he feels this is letting Barkley just shoot his load here, and then he'll come on. Nunn looks almost bored. He's talking to Barkley, talking to Carlos Padilla. I could use somebody down here to do commentary with me. Maybe you'd like to speak into the microphone. There you see Nunn talking to his corner while he's in the middle of an exchange with Barkley, saying, I'm going to come on now. And he does. That's interesting. Whatever you think of Michael Nunn, that's an extraordinary demonstration. And then he nails Barkley with six or seven excellent shots. Barkley's smiling, but Nunn is landing. Barkley isn't. Well, I ran Barkley as tough as nails and has one of the best chins you'll ever see. Smiles at Nunn again, but nothing else is happening for him. Ten around it. Nunn probably has stolen back with a good group of combinations here toward the end of the round. Barkley got him in a headlock again. Nunn hits him on the back of the head and says, get off of me. Again, after the round, things get wilder. Swell on the eye of Iran Barkley, and it's needed. That left eye is closing and closing badly.
And back with the left hook. Now, what did I say? Mm-hmm. Put them together and don't hesitate.
Come on.
Eddie Aliano working in the corner of Iran Barkley. He's one of the best cut men in the business. There's Roberto Duran. You saw him in the exhibition earlier tonight. He thought Barkley would win this match. So far, he... like most great champions, doesn't seem to be a great prognosticator, because Barkley would appear anyway to be way behind. Duran, the last man, of course, to fight Iran Barkley, beating him in that close decision for the WBC title. We're in round 11. It's scheduled for 12. Unless I am very wrong, and I have been in the past, Iran Barkley would need a knockout to beat Michael Nunn. Nunn has primarily won most of these rounds by boxing, which he's doing right here. The left eye of Barkley is closed, just about. Now, Michael Nunn, while he has a good right hook, doesn't have a devastating right hook to the head. He's pushed down by Barkley. And there's where those loose ropes become a factor. We talked about it earlier, the safety factor. Nunn went down because those ropes were so loose. So ropes that have helped him before, cushioned blows given by Barkley, hurt him there. Well, Barkley's been primarily ineffective the last three rounds, but Nunn has not been that much more effective offensively. The movement of Nunn giving Barkley all kinds of fits. This is how Sambu Kalembe beat Barkley, boxing him over 15 rounds. Jabs of Nunn, not really landing too well. Right hand by Barkley. Nunn with the jab, and Barkley missing with the right hand. So the firepower of Nunn early is gone now. He has landed some big shots, but not that many in the last four or five rounds. He's been primarily pecking away at Iran Barkley. They said only one man previous has put Iran Barkley out. That was Robbie Sims, who was not known as a devastating puncher, and yet he did put Barkley out. And other bigger punchers have failed to knock Iran out. To give him his due, I think Iran's defense has been better in this bout. Big hook by Barkley. Better than some thought. Did he hurt Nunn with that shot? We'll see. Michael moving about the ring, may have been stunned by that left hook. And that's where Michael Nunn has a big advantage, though. If he gets hurt by a punch, he can motor away, as he did. This might be a round that you could put in the bank of Iran Barkley, though. There haven't been that many of them. Would it be enough to help him win a decision? is this win by Michael Nunn dazzling enough, if it is a win, to make him a superstar? He's certainly already considered one of the great boxers around today. That'll do it for round 11. And a bout that many people thought would not go the distance looks like it's going to. Let's listen.
Relax, Mike. It's the last round.
I got you comfortably ahead, but...
Okay, last one, Mike. Last one.
We know that. I got you comfortably ahead, but I want you to have to lay some leather on this round. Okay?
The bandage. Bandage.
Here's where Michael Nunn was pushed down by Iran Barkley. Not a knockdown, clearly. Here's where Michael Nunn got nailed with a very big left hook. Did this hurt him? See if we can judge here. No, I don't think so. That landed on his neck more than his jaw. At first, I thought it did hurt him. There, I don't think it did. Barkley has landed some good left hooks, but probably not enough.
And final round, let's have a round of applause.
You see the left eye of Barkley. It has been swollen and close to being shut for about five rounds, but ironically has not posed that big a problem. And why? Because Michael Nunn, not known as a big right hook artist. Talking to Barkley, dancing. Barkley's waving to him to come on. Now they're yelling at each other. Well, they're not punching, they're yelling at each other. And since we can't hear what they're saying, I can't tell you who's winning the debate. Nunn with the jab and more jabs. And the uppercut by Nunn. For Michael Nunn, boxing his way to a victory is certainly acceptable, but is it what everybody wants from him, and is it enough? Now, there's Barkley stepping on his foot. I'm telling you that Nunn is ahead. I assume he is, but the final verdict belongs to the judges. And it may be closer than I have, but I would estimate Barkley to win two or three rounds at the most. Others may disagree with me on that. Nunn is telling Carlos Padilla to get out of his way. He wants to move. Padilla now is warning Nunn. Hey, I'll tell you what, I think Michael Nunn's got a good case. Carlos Padilla's not supposed to be in his way. Particular crowd, because he's coming after Nunn. They want Michael Nunn to do a little bit more offensively. And now Nunn is doing it as they wail away in the inside. And remember, in the first round, this is how it started, with big punches being landed by both men. Oh, good right hand by Michael Nunn. Now there, Nunn did not capitalize. He could have countered when Barkley fell off to his right. A minute left to go in this round, and in this bout, Barkley wailing away with shots, Nunn pecking away with the jab. A fairly close 12th round. Will it figure into a decision? We don't know. Now Nunn coming on, landing his jab in some combinations. Not setting down as well on his punches as he did earlier. There's the left hand by Nunn. The judges be swayed by the crowd kind of shifting toward Barkley and by the fact that Michael hasn't endeared himself to the referee, Carlos Padilla. Though certainly no warnings have been given. No one has been down in this bout. I don't think anyone has been hurt really seriously. Only the swelling over the left eye of Iran Barkley is the only mark on either man. Big uppercut by Nunn. He's landed enough of those. Holds his hand up in victory. Michael Nunn is lifted aloft. Certainly his handlers feel that he won the match. I would tend to agree. I thought Michael Nunn won most of the rounds in this match.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's the official scoring. Keith McDonald scores the bout. 114, 114, he has it even. When Hamada scores it, 115 to 113. And Art Laurie scores it, 116 to 113. For the winner by majority decision. And still, IBF middleweight champion of the world, Michael, second to none.
Well, not quite the performance we might have expected from Michael Nunn, despite his victory. Indeed, the promoter, Bob Arum, was talking afterwards about pulling out of future fights involving Nunn because of his lack of entertainment value. We'll see. But at least encouragement there for Britain's Michael Watson, I would have thought. Well, next week, we change tack with golf dominating.